of you on. Good morning. Thank you for joining me. This is Watercolor Wednesday Live, and I appreciate you spending your Wednesday morning with me. I've got a really fun project for you today, so I hope some of you will be following along. I'm getting my comments set up so that I can see who's on here. So send me a hello, and I will send you a hello back. Okay, there we go. All right, and Claire is on, thankfully, so she can answer some questions. I hope some of you will be following along. So now we are going to have a list available for all of us who are gonna be on live. So that's Kendra, Claire, and myself. And you can find those supply lists on our blog. So you can either go to the Art Impressions blog, if you know how to get there, or you can go to our website, artimpressions.com, click on the blog, and it will take you over there. And at the very top of the blog, you'll see a banner, and it will have the words live video supply lists. And you can click on that, and you can see the supply lists that we're going to be using for the lives. So those of you who want to follow along, we'd love to have you do that with us. This is something new that Clara set up, and I think it's going to be really, really great. You can have all your supplies out and ready to go. So today, speaking of supplies, we're going to make a slimline card. It's going to be so fun. So if you want to, before we actually get started, if you want to cut a slimline card, if you're following along with me, cut one that is, this one is 3 inches by 8 inches. So get your watercolor paper out, cut a 3x8 strip of watercolor paper like this one, and you will be ready to follow along. In the meantime, I'm gonna say hi to some of my friends who are on here. Good morning, Ruth Ailes, hello. Vicki Fries, hello, thanks for watching. Barbara Meyer, Barb Bartz, hello to you. Sandy Fetzer, Dee Fury, hello. Andrea Johnson, happy St. Patrick's Day. Sandy Fetzer, hello. Barbara Meyer, Trisha, thank you so much, you guys, for following. Thanks so much for joining me today. These are so fun to do. I love doing these, and I've been kind of working my way through the simple scenes and doing lots of the new release, so we are going to use some of the new release. If you are following along, you saw that on the supply list. Let me show you what we're going to make. We're going to make a slimline card, and this is what it is. So I'm gonna do a lot of holding it up because there are a lot of small areas, and it is pretty long and tall, so it's hard to keep it all in the screen. So I will be holding it up so that you can see. If you look really closely, you can see that the birdhouses are the village, the little village from the newest release. So we're gonna turn those little village houses into birdhouses and make this really cute little birdhouse pole with the little cat sleeping in the pot. So that will be really, really fun to do. And this is, you know, I would categorize this as an intermediate project, but that doesn't mean that if you're a beginner, you want to skip over it. Give it a try. It's all the same technique. So there's nothing really hard about it. It's just that it's a little more involved. It takes a little bit more time and a little bit more planning. In other words, we use the positioner. That's pretty much what it is. So give it a try. And if you are new to this technique, be sure to catch Kendra's lives once a week on Tuesdays, 5 o'clock Pacific time. It's back to basics. So if you're new or you need a refresher, those are really great tutorials because they're very basic. And she kind of walks you through all those simple techniques that you kind of need to know to move on to the next level. And I get to do the projects that are a little more challenging, those intermediate projects for those of you who've been doing this a long time and need a challenge. That's my job, to challenge you. So I see Kim is on there. Laura, hello. Hello to all of you who are on here. Thank you so much. I love seeing all of you from all over the place. Wanting to start Bible journaling? Yes, I am going to do that. I am on Instagram. I have a personal account called Bonnie Krebs Bible Journaling. So I am going to be doing more tutorials on there as well. So I am just trying to get enough time to get everything in. But that does remind me, when you're doing these when you're doing these slimline cards like this, this is a perfect example of something that you could put in a journal. I think this would be so cute to put in the, you know, in this on the side, in the column on the side, because you need a long, narrow space. And this kind of thing will work perfectly in there. I love doing this. And you can do this process, you know, this technique in a journal. You just need this. So let me just show you what this is. This is Golden Absorbent Ground. It's basically a primer that you put onto your page and turns your page into watercolor paper. It is just the coolest thing. You need a brush like this, a flat brush. These are both available on our website. So if you want to do this technique in a journal or in a Bible, you can. You can do it in any book, actually, any paper. So if you're interested in that, check out Bonnie Krebs Bible Journaling on Instagram. There are also tutorials on YouTube. There are tutorials on Instagram, too, on how to prep your page and do that. Diane Mason, hello. Carol, hello. Maggie, hello. I hope you guys enjoy this project. It was really, really fun. I'll have to show you two versions of it because I did one and then I thought, oh, I need more birdhouses than that. And so I put way more birdhouses on there. And then I went and I thought, you know what? This is going to take 3 hours to get through this class. So I just went back to 7. I had 11 and then I went back to 7. So I did tone it down a bit. But it's a really, really fun project. I love when you can take something that you have and kind of use it for a totally different purpose like this. So it makes your stamp so much more versatile and it trains you to kind of think outside of the box a little bit, which is what I love to do. So I hope you guys will follow along with me and, you know, the next tutorials, Kendra's next tutorial, you'll be able to see that supply list on the blog. So those of you who are just joining, you can see a supply list for the lives on our blog. So go to the blog either from the website or straight to the blog. And at the very top banner, you'll see live video supply list. Click that and you'll be able to see what we're going to be using for the next live so that you can follow along. Okay, so those of you who are following along with me, if you haven't already, cut a 3x8 piece of watercolor paper like this. A slimline card is actually 3.5 by 8.5. That's the actual size, but I cut it a little bit smaller so that I can, you can see I mounted it on some really pretty paper. So you can do that. You can cut it down just a little bit. Okay, are you guys ready to get going? Let me just see who all is on here really quick. Dee, I have 9 bird feeders in my yard. Okay, you know what? You could put 9 on this post. You can just fill it up. So it is really fun. And you can also jam these closer together. So I have 7 on here. There are 7 on this. And you can see that you can move them up a little bit closer and you could fit more on there. So you can make as many birdhouses as you would like to make. Okay, are you guys ready to get going? Let me switch my camera over and I will try to follow along with your questions. So feel free to ask if you have any questions about what I'm doing and especially about this technique. Let me get this on here so that I don't cut you off. That's always the most stressful part of doing these lives is that we don't lose you in the process. Okay, so I am going to drop this down a little bit and try to fit as much fit as much into the screen as I can. And like I said, I will try to remember to hold things up so that you can see. And this will, of course, like all the others, stay archived onto Facebook so that you can go back and watch this. Some of these things are so small. I think we're good there. Okay, I've got my paper right here. I've got my water and my palette. So I'm ready to get going. I'm going to, so here's our project. So let me show it up to you up close. I've got 7 birdhouses on here, and it just kind of goes down to the little cat down in the bottom, all the way down to this little bird down at the very bottom down here. So they're really fun because you can just keep going. I love these things that just kind of build like this. This is a really simple concept, but it kind of reminds me of spring And I'm kind of ready for spring. I don't know if you guys are, but I sure am. Here's my first one. Okay, so this has 11 birdhouses on it. There's barely room for the cat in here. And I really like this simpler tone. Now, this is Kim. So those of you who have seen her tutorials, my daughter Kim, she loves bright colors. She has animals in every one of her tutorials, I think. So I was inspired by her to get the animals out and get out the bright colors. But this is normally where I go. And I don't know if this is the case for you, but I love more muted colors. I love a really simple palette. But you can see the difference here and how that just changes the whole look of everything. So don't forget that you can mix up the colors and you can change everything just by doing that. You know, changing this to fall, you know, maybe the, maybe there's just some dried branches and, you know, a lot of oranges and yellows in there. And then of course, spring with all the bright colors. So, you know, there is a lot to be said for, you know, the really simple tones like this. It's a very soothing. Maybe that's why I like it so much. But I also love this. So we're going to do the bright colors. We're going to do the bright colors today. But keep in mind that you can do something simple like this. Also, I wanted to show you something that a friend of mine gave me. And there was a question on one of Kendra's tutorials about how to coat your finished project so that it doesn't get ruined with water. So if you were going to create this card and send it in the mail to someone, if it got water on it, it would ruin your painting because you can always go back to these. If they're uncoated or untreated, you can go back to them and just keep pulling the water out of the color out of the lines, keep adding to them. But when they're finished and you want a finished product, you can spray it. And I've always just, you know, when that's the case, I've always just sprayed it with a clear coat, something like Krylon, to spray it over the top. But I met my friend Donna for breakfast and she gave me this. Now, I don't know, this may be familiar to a lot of you. I've never used this before. This is the Tim Holtz Distressed Micro Glaze. Now, we don't carry this on our website, but this is available on Amazon. And I think it's about $9. I looked to make sure that you could get this on Amazon. If you've never used this, it's almost like a, let me show you what it looks like. It's almost like a waxy paste. You put it on with your finger like this, and you just rub it on. And I wish you could see on here what it actually looks like, but it kind of creates a really nice matte finish. It actually, deepens your color a little bit and creates a really nice finish onto here. It's the most natural looking thing I think that I've seen. And I think it works great. It's less messy than a spray and it really would go a long way. So like I said, Kathy, this is what you use. Okay, this is probably nothing new to a lot of you. I have not used this. So I just really, really like this. Once you're done putting that on, and I think you wanna put it on pretty liberally, you just take a paper towel and just kind of rub off the excess. And now your image is coated and you don't have to worry about anything getting on here and ruining it. Do you see how that just beads up on there? So see the water beading up? This will protect your image so that you can mail it or send it or put it in the kitchen or somewhere where you don't have to worry about being ruined, it being ruined after you've spent all this time on it. So I would, you know, like I said, I've always used a spray on, but I really like this stuff. Distress Microglaze. It really feels like kind of waxy, but I think it would go a long ways. And I think it's probably worth the $9, you know, just get it on Amazon. And I think it will be great. So I will be using that in the future. So thanks, Donna, my friend Donna, who gave me that when we were at breakfast. One more thing I wanted to tell you is that I use this post-it tape all the time. We used to carry this on our website. I use it all the time. If you've seen me do any tutorials, I probably use this tape as a mask. They don't make this particular one anymore, so we don't have it on our website, but they do make this. So I don't know what the difference is. It's just the container. It's the same thing. It's the exact same thing. I also got this on Amazon because I wanted to make sure that it's the same thing. So you can use the post-it note. This is way more economical to use
These are fairly inexpensive, and I wish now I had written down how much I paid for it, but it was not super expensive. And it is, it's got a lot on here. 19 yards. Okay, that'll last you a long time. So you can see how much is on here. I use this stuff all the time. I love it. And you can use it over and over again. So every time you need to create a mask, you can just use this, especially if you're masking off an area. So, you know, if you want to make something that just fits in a boundary, you can mask off, you know, the sides and create a square, and then you've got a boundary. So anyway, someone told me when I said we don't carry it anymore, someone said, look on Amazon, they have it. So thank you for that tip. I also wish I knew who remembered who told me that, but thank you for that tip, because I did order it and it is the exact same thing. So I feel good telling you that you can now get it. So Amazon, don't we love Amazon? Holy cow. Love it. How do we ever get along without Amazon? So all of those things are on there. So anyway, let's get started now with our project. So we're going to start out with this slimline card, and I can't fit it all on here, but I will do my best to kind of move it around. So let me just, something's bugging me here. This camera's crooked. Okay, there we go. We're going to draw a line down the center. So I am going to, well, first, let me back up. Let me tell you what I'm using. How about that? Let's do that first. So we're going to use the village. This is the little village. This is from the new release. We're going to use four of these little houses. So this one, this one, this one, and this one. So just four, these four of these little houses. Now we're not going to use the windows or the chimneys. We're just going to use the outside structure of the little village. Okay. We're also going to use these two small birdhouses that are part of this set, the bird bath set. Now, if you don't have this one, you have some other birds, or you don't happen to have this one, you can just use those little village again. And the same with these two. So if you don't have the village, you can just do these. You know, by the time you color them different colors, you can't really tell that it's the same. It's the same stamp. Now I'm going to use this container set, the ornate container set. You can use whichever container set you have. Now I'm going to use this one, but I opted to make it simpler because I have so much going on here on this post. So I took all this ornate stuff off and I just inked the outside edge. So just around the edge, and then I added my own detail. So that again is up to you. You can use any container. You could have used any of these containers that are on here. They would have worked great. The cat. So I'm using this little sleeping guy from the cat set, this one right here. So I'm also going back to the foliage set. This is set one. This is the very basics of basics. We're going to use the little vine here. If you have a different vine, you can certainly use that. This is foliage set four. We're going to use these little detailed grasses here. But, you know, what I'm showing you now are the accessories. So the extra elements. So we've gone through the basic needs of the cart and the composition, the pot, the birdhouses, the cat. Now the rest of it is the filler. And this is where you can use what you have. You can change this up. Now this is just what I used. But if you don't necessarily have all of these sets, use the sets that you have. If you have a vine or a long stem, those are all going to work. In here, I picked this large dot from this set. This is the garden the garden wagon set. I chose this one. If you don't have this and you have this one, we're going to use this little long stem from here. You can use these little dots also. So you can use these two if you don't necessarily have the wagon. From the branches set, my little favorite here, we're going to add that one. And that is all we need to get going on this project. Okay, so now we are ready to get started. The first thing we're going to do is draw a line straight down the center. So I'm going to measure this. This is 3 inches. And so the center, let me find my pencil here. The center, of course, is at 1.5. So I'm just going to make two little lines at 1.5. And just draw a line straight down the center. This is a 6-inch ruler, so it's about the right size here. So straight down the middle like that. And then I have this little clear ruler, so I can line up the line that I just made at the 1/8 mark. And that's what I'm going to do. So I'm going to make a 1/8 mark on this side and a 1/8 mark on this side. So I'm going to line this up, and you can see, let me hold this up just a little bit closer. So you can see my line. See my line at the very top? That's my center line. I'm going to line that up, see, onto the 1/8 mark, and then just draw a line on there. So basically what we're doing is we're getting a 1/4 inch post, and then we're going to erase the middle. Okay, so we've got this done. Take all this middle out of here, and we've got a 1/4 inch post right into the center of the card. So I am also trying to watch your comments, you guys. So if you have any questions, be sure to ask me on here. I will try to, I'm trying to get better at that, watching the comments and teaching you this tutorial. So now the first thing we're going to do is get our little birdhouses onto the post. So I'm going to move them over here. And we've actually got 6 that we're using. So these are the 4 from the village set, and these are the 2 from the birdhouse set. So you can see they're pretty similar in size. We're not going to ink the detail on these 4. These are okay to ink, but these 4 we're going to leave the windows off and the little chimneys off in this case. So let's start with this simple one right here. Now, if you don't have a positioner, I would really encourage you to invest in one, because I use them all the time, especially when we get into these intermediate projects. You really need to have some kind of positioning tool to help you place things. So I've already, just for time's sake, I went ahead and stamped all these little houses and everything onto my positioner, into the onto my acrylic sheet. So basically what it is, you're inking this and you're stamping it into the corner like this, and now you can see exactly where to place it. So I'm going to place this little guy right here at the very top of the post, right kind of right in the center. And then I'm going to ink it with a light color. So these are very small, and we're going to color them with bright colors, some yellow. So we don't necessarily want really dark lines on here. And this is a very light, it's kind of similar to that dark brown color. It's just a very lighter, much lighter tone. And I think it works really good with these. Now you're going to ink just the outside. And what I've found is that if you tip your pen down a little bit, instead of going straight across, or instead of coloring straight on here, you won't get, it's easier to get just the edge. So you're just going to kind of come along here and just get the edge. See what I mean by just kind of tipping this down a little bit? And even if you do get some of the windows in here, it's okay. It's okay, because most of the time they'll just wash out. So now we've got this positioned where we want it. And now we've got our little house right up here. And so we're going to do them all the same way. So the next one we're going to do, and remember when you're looking at these, they're opposite. So, you know, if this one is going, if this one's going on the left side, you make sure it's facing to the right. So I did that a few times too. So you wouldn't be the only one. I just, you know, it seems like there's always at least one mess up on something, and that's just how it goes. And usually we can find a way to fix it or laugh about it. Okay, so I'm doing the same thing here. I'm going over the, just the outside edge. And I'm gonna find this one on my acrylic plate, which is right here. This is the one I'm doing right here. And I'm just going to put it over a little bit, kind of down below the first one, and just make sure it's straight. Place my positioner back in here and stamp this little guy right there. Okay, so we've got that one in place. So let's go on to the next one. I'm gonna use this same little guy again. Find him on here. Now, we're gonna erase these pencil lines. So this is the nice thing about creating the post with pencil instead of using a fine tip marker, because we can erase these lines once we've got all these little houses in place. We'll just erase these lines. So that looks good right there. And I'm just going to ink this one up again with my light brown. If you don't have this light brown, use your dark brown and just stamp it off. That also will work just fine. Okay, so we've got two houses on there. Let's go down and do something different. We're going to add this one on here. And I have got that stamped also on here. And I'm going to put that right in the center, just like this. And ink this guy up with the same, same brown, light brown. And stamp that right in the center like that. That looks good. So let's go on. Let's put one over here to the side. So that would be this one facing this way. And let me see where that one is. That one right here, this guy. And again, I'm gonna place it over, kind of over the top of the post and just right down below. So that's a good spot right there. And then ink again, just the edge. Tip your marker just a little bit. And then stamp that right on here. That looks good. So let's just keep going. Let's do this little guy. Just to kind of switch it up a little bit. We'll put this one here. And like I said, you can change this up as much as you want to. And you know, it just seems like every time you do it, it's going to be different anyway. If I had made this 20 times, every single one of them would look different. So that's the fun thing about doing, this technique. And that's why you sign it, because every one is your own work of art. Okay, so let's go back to that large one again. And we've got 3, 4, 5, 6. So we've got 7 on here. Let's put this one right in the center. Let me find that large one again. This guy right here. No, not that guy. This guy. This guy right here. Let's put this one in the center. Drop it down just a little bit. And which one is that? This one right here. This part always takes the longest, you know, getting your basic image in there. And once you have the composition kind of finished, then the rest is really, really fun. Whoops, and I just moved that. So let's put this back on here. That looks good. Huff on that a little bit. And there we go. So we've got our little houses on here. You can see they're all stamped on here really lightly. And you can see that none of them have the bottom onto them. So we're going to do that also. We're going to draw that in. But in the meantime, or first we're going to erase that pencil line in the center. So make sure that they're really dry before you try to erase this pencil line. So only where the little birdhouses are. Just as the line kind of runs through the birdhouse, erase that area. So let me hold this up. So you can see where that post ran through. Now this one, I've left this little pencil line here. So I've left this, just erase this area where it kind of runs through the birdhouses. Everybody see that okay? Now we're going to go through and we're going to put the bottom onto these. Now here's where you can change them up a little bit too. Maybe you want these a little bit bigger. You can drop that line down. It doesn't have to be right here. You can drop this line down a little bit and you want to make that line go straight across with your pencil. So just like this. And just like this. And then these here are going to be just a tiny bit of an angle as they go up, just a tiny bit. And just use your pencil. It's just the easiest way. So just get the bottoms in there. And you can make, you know, if you're using all the same, if you, for example, don't have these, or you have, you know, you don't know, you're using the same little structure, you can make them, you can make a few of them double, you know, make them really tall and have like, you know, four little holes in here. So you can kind of change it up a little bit. Okay, so now that that's done, let's go ahead and stamp in the pot down at the bottom. So we're going to use this one here. And like I said, I'm going to leave this detail out. I don't really want all this detail in here because we've got so much going on this post that it kind of takes away from our focal point, which is our little birdhouses. So I'm going to use my positioner again to make sure that I have this in the center. And I'm just going to ink the outside. And I'm going to use two colors. So the dark brown 969 and 565. So we're going to use these two. We're going to start with the dark brown and just kind of do the same thing. So you're kind of tipping your marker down. So you're getting the side of it. You're not getting this edge here. So you're kind of going around just like this. And then over the top, the blue. So I've just got the edge. And we're going to use the positioner. So stamp it off on here and then put it maybe right about here because we want to leave some space at the bottom. We want to leave some space at the bottom for that little bird. So probably right here is pretty good. Stamp that on there. That's exactly what we want. So these things are really versatile too. These little pots. Always keep that in mind when you're using these things because you have a lot of options with these. So let me just show you really quickly. If you're looking at these pots, you have a lot of options because you can ink just the lines that you want to use. For example, you could take this bottom line. That could be the top of your pot. You could take this bottom line off. On here, you could take the whole pedestal off. And just use this bowl, or you can make it really small just with this section right here. And again, we took all the detail off of here. Here's another one. You could just use this middle section right here, or make it really short, just this part. So really keep that in mind when you're using stamps because there's a lot of options here besides these four pots. Every one of these pots has multi uses. You can use them lots and lots of different ways. Okay, so we're going to do the same thing here with the pencil lines and erase those. Make sure that your pot is dry before you try to erase that. And then we're going to now stamp the little cat inside here. So, of course, we're going to use a positioner. And I'm going to ink this in that same brown. Again, I'm going to leave this cat white, so I'm just going to use this really light brown and stamp it. Wow, that is really light. You know what? Let's go a little bit darker just to get it onto the positioner, and then we'll stamp it off. Because we've got to be able to see where that's going. That's way better. Now we can see exactly where this little guy is going into the pot. So I'm going to now just kind of clean that off, stamp that off. I just had a baby wipe over on the side. And clean that off. And now I'm going to just use that light brown. And before I do, okay, see how this little cat is kind of hanging over the pot? We want to cover that so that we don't stamp over the edge like that. We want to look like he's kind of tucked down inside. So I'm going to use a piece of Post-it tape. And I'm just going to cover the mouth of the little pot. so that we can stamp this in here. Now I can see that I can stamp over that a little bit, put him in here just like this, kind of a little bit over to the side. And now I can ink this up with that light brown. And I'm going to add a little of the blue to it over the top and then stamp it off. And just stamp it off on a piece of scrap. And now we can take this off, and you can see that he's tucked down now inside that little pot, and we haven't stamped over. Now I've cut a mask, so I'll give you a minute to do that. Stamp this on a piece of post-it note or a piece of post-it tape, and just cut a little mask because we're going to cover him up so that we can stamp all the flowers and everything into the pot. So just cover him up like that. And in the meantime, we're going to start adding some color now to these little birdhouses because we've got kind of got everything now in place. So you can see we've got all of our little birdhouses in here. So let's start at the top and let's start adding some color in here. This is the fun part. Anybody have any questions so far? Anybody have any questions? Everybody following along okay and getting this? This is not hard. It's just a little time consuming. So let's add some color. We're going to add some pink. This is number 725. We're going to add some blue. This is the 526. And some yellow. This is 993. And then let's add a little bit of green so that we can kind of mix that in a little bit. This is the warm green. So this is because we've got a lot of warm colors going on. We've got pinks and yellows and this warm blue. We're gonna use the warm green. So this is the number 177. What number pencil do you use? You know what? The simplest one I have. This is a number 2. Just a simple pencil, Ruth Ann. Nothing fancy about it. I have really simple tools. So the biggest thing I think is that it's a fine tip. Make sure it's sharpened. That makes a huge difference. You wouldn't think so, but it really does when you're doing these, all these little tiny areas. Make sure this is really sharp. And, you know, let me just show you something on, you know, on these little birdhouses. Okay, so when you're doing these little birdhouses, this will change your perspective a bit. So the way that we've got this set up is that you're kind of standing and you're looking at this straight on. Now you could change the bottom. So let's just say here's our little birdhouse right here. Okay, so here's the little birdhouse. If you change the bottom, now this makes it look like you're looking up above. You see what I mean? Either this way or this way. You can see the bottom. So if you're looking up at it, you'll be able to see the bottom of the birdhouse down under here. If you're looking straight at it, you're going to see it straight on. Does that kind of make sense, or did I just confuse everybody and make it way worse? I hope not. Okay, so let's keep going here. Let's keep going on with the colors. So now I'm going to just start brushing this color on. Oh, I need some blue on here. So let's get some blue on here. This is the dark blue, number 565. And I'm going to start putting my color on. Now keep it really light. Keep it really, really light. And honestly, we don't really have to do much by pulling the color out of the lines. It kind of will do that on its own because it is so light. It just kind of will start to pull out. You can, if you want to, do that step. But Let's just start adding the color like this. And remind me if I go off the screen, you guys. This thing is so tall that I don't want to go off the screen and have you miss something. Stay in each section. That's really, really important when you're doing these little things. Stay in each section on its own. Don't cross these lines. We don't want to lose these lines. So let's add some, let's put some purple on here. Let's add some purple. Start out really light because we can always come back in and add more color. And you can see I'm kind of leaving a little space, you know, along the line. I'm not coloring over this little line here. That's really, really important that you do that. And let's leave this one, let's just leave this one white. So I'm gonna pull a little of this color out of here. And I'm just gonna take some of this. Wait, is that the blue? No, here's the blue. We want the blue. Here's the blue. I'm gonna take some of this and just put a little bit along the side. Because this one is rounded, so we want to see that highlight in here, even though it's tiny. We want to see the highlight in the center. And then let's go on. Let's add some blue to this one. This little house, so cute. Sending somebody a card with birdhouses, like it's really happy, isn't it? I mean, you can't help but smile at it. This would be a great encouragement card to send to someone. Okay, so let's go on now. Let's get some yellow in here. I can hear Kim saying to me over my shoulder, the yellow, Mom, the yellow. This is her favorite color. She loves yellow. And darker in here. We'll get into that. You know, these areas that'll be in the shadows, we'll get into that and make them a little bit darker. And let's add some blue now to this one. This little guy. Keep it really light, you know, when you're starting out. Just keep it really light. You can always go back in and add a little more color. Okay? Kind of starting to look like Easter eggs, isn't it? Maybe because I kind of have Easter on my mind. That's what it kind of reminds me of. Okay, so let's keep going here. I'm gonna add some color now to the roofs. Let's just change it up a little bit. Let's put some bright colors on here. And maybe some blue down here. A little blue on the side. And let's get a little brown. So here's our dark brown. We'll just take our very light bit of this brown, just super light, and let's put it on here, this one. And maybe on this one. Just, you know, this is all up to you. You know, where you want to put these, you know, these colors. Because it really changes things when you switch up the colors. Just a ton. And we can put some detail in later too. Okay, so we've got a couple more roofs here. Let's put a little brown in this one. This guy here. And you can see that I'm leaving some white spaces too. That is so important that you don't color everything in the same. Just try to leave those little white spaces. Okay, I'm gonna hold this up now so you can see the color in here. So you can see how light everything is. You know, it's really, really light. And we can go back in and add some more color, but we're just kind of getting the color blocked in right now to this area. Okay, so I'm going to now just take a little bit more of this and kind of darken this area that is going to be in the shadow. that would be this, probably this area here too. So it'd be darker back in here. And then this purple. This area back in here, kind of in the shady part. I think this is the funnest part, adding the color and the detail, you know, adding the flowers. It just, it all kind of comes together. Once you get all the basic pieces in, it's just, it's so fun doing this part. Okay, so now we are ready to put our little, the little holes in. And we're going to do that with a pencil first. So again, you know, the pencil is kind of your best friend. It is for me. I do everything with a pencil first because I can just always erase it. So if I want to put any detail in, I can do that and see how it looks. And then if I don't like it, I just take it out. So I'm going to start with a little circle here on this one. And then a little circle. I'm going to put the circle on the side over here just to kind of mix it up a little bit. Let's put this one over here. These are already on here, so we don't have to worry about those. And then this one. And then maybe with this one, we could put one here and maybe one here. So we could put two on. Okay, so now we're gonna really darken those areas. We want this to really pop. So we're gonna take now the twin tone, this is the blue, the dark blue. And what I want you to do is try to leave a little edge. And I'm gonna color one of these and then I'm gonna hold it up so that you can see what I mean by the edge. And especially these that are on the side. Now, can you see that? Let me just make sure this is on here clear. Can you see this little tiny edge right here? Even these little tiny details make a big difference. You're giving this little opening an edge to the wood. So you just want to leave just that little area, anything that's on the side. Now, when it's straight on like this, it's not so important to do that, but any of these things that are to the side, you would be able to see that little edge when you're looking at this. And it's going to make things look a lot more realistic if you do that. I'll hold it up when I get all of these done so you can see. Just gonna, this one here, you know, you can kind of see it a little bit, but, and if you leave it, that's, it's okay, even if it's just tiny. You know, any of these that are really, you know, small on the side, they're gonna be more of an oval than they are round. Okay, you can see how these really, this thing's really popped out now, can't you? See those little areas? I hope you can see that. It's just tiny little details, but it really, really makes a difference. So now let's go in with the other twin tone. Now this is the brown, and we're gonna go in with little perches. So these ones that are off to the side, you're gonna see more of that perch. So you're going to make a straight line, just like this. See that little perch right there? Gonna make a straight line. Same with this one. So underneath, start where the hole is, right underneath the hole, and just make that little perch. This one, you're not gonna see as much of it. So this is going to be a smaller one. See how small this one is? This one's really small too. This one will be a little bit longer. This one's already on here, so you can just darken this one. This one will be small. This one will be longer. You guys all see that? Little things, you guys, make a big difference. It's all about showing the perspective of things. And this really, really, really makes a difference. Here's the other thing that we want to do, and that is to put a shadow on. And I'm going to use my tiny little brush. This is number one. And when you drop a little shadow underneath there, it really makes a difference. And you're just gonna come from where that, where it kind of attaches to the birdhouse, and you're going to make a line straight down. You see that? See how that just changed everything? Whoops, we forgot one. See how that little shadow just changes everything? It really does. Details, but it really, really, really makes a difference. Okay, so let's take that little, let's take some more of that blue, and let's just put a little shadow underneath the overhang of these little houses. We'll just do this for now. Whoops, I keep getting into that purple, and I mean to get into the blue. So we'll just do this part for now, and then we'll come back to these houses again when we're finishing up. So again, you can see how this just really pops things out when you put a shadow in like that. And then that's what we're trying to do. We're trying to make something look three-dimensional. So it doesn't look like it's a coloring book, something that we just painted. We want it to look like a painting. And back in here. And when we finish up, we'll put some more detail into these little houses. But see how they're kind of shaping up? Starting to look more realistic, aren't they? Not just flat. It's just these little things that make a difference. And if you do it, if you just learn to do it, you know, oh, well, when I make a birdhouse and I put a perch, I'm going to put a shadow underneath it. If you just learn to do it, you'll be so much happier with how things turn out because they're going to look so much more realistic. Okay, so let's go on now, and we are going to add our foliage in, and maybe let's work on the pot a little bit. Let's go down here. Let's work on the pot a little bit so that we can get our foliage in. So I'm going to start out by pulling the color out of the line. It's going to be really light because we've just got the outline. We've just got the outline only. And this is really up to you. You can paint this whatever color you want. And I, you know, for me, I kept it really simple because I have so much going on up here. But you can definitely make this a color. And I'm just adding a little shadow in here because we always have a shadow if something is white. And I'm kind of leaving this little pot white. So I'm just adding a little shadow. Even though it's white, it's never uncolored. It's always going to have a color, and that's the shadow that we're adding. Okay, and then we can add some detail to it. So maybe something bright, like some pink, is always so cute. When you're adding a detail like this, make sure you put a bend in it. That also will, whoever's looking at it will see that it's rounded. It's all to give the illusion that things are three-dimensional. If you made a straight line across, that would look like this pot is flat. Absolutely flat. Okay, so we're done with that. Let's go ahead now and put our foliage in. And I'm going to use this little marker here, 177, and the vine. This is still my favorite, you guys, after all these years. I don't even know how old this thing is. It is so old, but it's hard to beat it because it just works so great. And I just keep going back to it all the time. So we're going to stamp it in here a bunch of times. Now we've got our little cat protected, so we don't have to worry about him getting inked up. He's going to be fine. And, you know, we can hang some of these, you know, over the top. I feel like he's kind of crushed the vines and everything because he's in this pot. So let's just hang some stuff down over the edge like this. Make sure I stay in the center here. And then we're going to just kind of grow this up from here. And this part, you can put as much of this on as you want to. And I'm going to just kind of fit in a little bit here and there. Maybe some this way. Turn your paper. You know, it's so much easier to stamp when you're turning your paper. Maybe you put a little one up here. Where else do we have room? Maybe there, maybe here. Kind of wherever we have room. And then let's start at the top and we can start adding our water to it. Just dab. You can start pulling out some of the color from the little birdhouses too. You can pull that to the outside and get more of a background. I really like the abstract look. So I'm always pulling color out from everywhere and kind of mixing it together. I think it really adds a lot. Now, if you like more of a clean look, you don't have to do that. You don't have to pull all this color out. You can keep. And just keep adding water and kind of working your way. Just dabbing, so no brush strokes. Just dabbing as we go. This is the fun part. It's just so fun. I love seeing how this comes together because it always looks like kind of a mess when you get the vines and stuff in. It's like, wow, that's really, really messy. But it just kind of all comes together, especially if you can remember to stamp it in a repeat. You know, at least 3 or 4 or 5 times is going to give you a much better result. And to soften all these little lines in here. Just so cute and so fun. Okay. So let's keep going here. And I'm going to add some shadows now to the post. So you can see where the post is now. Now that we've got our vines and stuff in, now the post is rounded. So we're going to see that shadow on either side, even if it's a small area. And just kind of blend it over so you see that highlight in the center. Just kind of blend it over. And then we're going to come back in here and we're going to make it a shadow underneath. Underneath. There'll be a shadow under here where all these little houses are. Okay, let me hold this up so that you can kind of see that. See that shadow underneath that post? Dot says, I had about 9 birdhouses in 1 tree. Oh, wow. And this reminds me of that. I loved it, but the sun and wind came here in Vegas. Oh, darn. My little granddaughter loves birds so much, Kendall Joy. She has, we call it her bird perch, and she sits in the living room. We have a large amount of bird feeders out our window as well. And she checks the birds out every morning, gets so excited when she sees a new bird that she doesn't recognize. Loves birds so much. Okay, so you can see that shadow on there. See how the post looks more rounded. We're starting to see this come together now. Okay, so let's keep going here. Let's add the flowers in, and then we'll come back at the very end. We'll put some more detail into these little birdhouses and finish up this cat. So we're going to take the long stem now. We're going to take that little long stem flower, and you can make this whatever color you want to. I'm just gonna do it in the blue. So this is that warm blue, number 526. And green on the vine. And stamp it in there a few times. So green on the vine. And just put this, you know, wherever. You can see I feel like this cat is just, he's really kind of mashing all of these flowers down. So I feel like there's some that are, you know, like hanging over like this. And I'm just doing the blooms now. I'm just kind of adding it to the vines. And then maybe I'll add some more vines in. So maybe some up here. Stamp it in there a few times. Just keep turning your paper. I hope I'm staying on the screen, you guys. But I'll hold it up again at the end. And basically, I'm just inking this in two colors. Two colors, the blue on the little petals and the green on the stem. Just kind of extending them out from that vine. Let's see, let's put another one back in here, maybe one in here. And now we can just kind of, actually, let me just do a couple more here. Just put as many of these in as you want. Okay, we got lots of blooms in here. Love it. So we're just gonna go and just touch the blooms, so not the stems. You don't wanna do anything to the stems. You wanna just leave those. And just keep moving this up so that you guys can see. Just touch the bloom. Just kind of let it do its thing. Okay, so let's come in now with the little dots. And I'm just gonna use the darker blues. This is the 565. And I'm just gonna put in some dots in here. Just kind of tap them in. I just love this detail of these little guys. And let's put some up here. Okay, starting to come together. So let's keep going here. I'm gonna add some sky now in the background. I also love doing this. Now this is also up to you. Again, if you like that clean look, you don't have to add so much into the background. But I always like to add just a little bit of blue back in here, just so that you can kind of see the background. I think it gives it a little more depth. And it's just the idea of it, you know, so you're just putting a little bit in here and there. Really lightly, and you're kind of just pushing the color. You know, when it comes to these little dots, you know, you can add a little bit of water to them if you want to, or you can just kind of leave them. I don't add much to it. I kind of like that detail. So I just kind of leave them most of the time. Okay, so we've got a little background in here. And just kind of drag out all this color. So fun. Okay, so let's add some detail now in here. Let's just come in here with a small brush. And just put some detail into these little roof lines maybe. Let's put some down in here. Maybe some little lines like this. It really adds a lot to do this. It's kind of worth it to take the time to add the detail. It just kind of changes everything up a bit. So let's take some of this, and actually I think I'm just gonna use the fine tip. This pink is really bright, so I'm just gonna use the fine tip and just kind of go like this. And really brighten that up. That is so cute. I just love this bright pink. And then maybe the same, maybe let's add some of that detail to this one. It's kind of put a line here. Like that. Doesn't have to be a lot. And maybe we put a little heart. On here. Let's see what else we can do. Darken this area. It's back in the shadows. Darken this under here. Always go back in later and kind of add detail here and there. Sometimes you don't know what to add until you've finished and walked away and then gone back again. And then you come back in and just add two or three little things and it just makes all the difference. So always keep that in mind that you can go back, you know. So let's take this little cat off now. Take him off. And we're going to erase these lines, of course. Take this off and let's put a little blue line right in here where the shadow would be. So he's kind of tucked in here, tucked down inside, and I'm going to leave him white. So I'm just going to pull some of this color out and just leave him white because he's really going to stand out amongst all these vines. And again, you know, just because he's white, doesn't mean he doesn't have color. He does. And let's just put a little color in his ears. Like this. And we can add a little shadow kind of, you know, across his back. Just like this, just to make it look like he's really in the vines. And then let's take the fine tip and really darken his little eyes. And actually maybe just right in here. Let me hold this up so that you can see that detail. He can just be really, really simple. Doesn't take a lot to do this. Hello, Therese. She says, hi, Bonnie. Sorry I'm late. You're never too late. You can jump in anytime, and this will stay archived on here, so you can catch anything that you have missed. So no worries. Okay, let's keep going here. We're going to finish up the bottom. And I'm just going to add the little grass onto the bottom here. Just walk it. You know, when you're stamping the grass, you're walking it. It's meant to kind of move along just like that, back and forth. And then you're going to take your brush and just pull that color out of the lines. Just drag that color up and out. And we can just add some shadows in here. You know, with this blue, just a little bit, kind of. We'd see lots of little shadows of all this stuff hanging over. Super easy. Don't overthink it, you guys. Don't overthink it. Just get it on there. It's all about the idea of it. Okay, so I'm going to add that little accent grass. I just love this grass so much because what I love about it is that you can stamp it over things, say like this, because it's really thin and small. And you can use parts of it. So you can use the top and turn it. And then if you want to, you could add, you know, something down into the bottom too. You can add more flowers down in there. So I'm going to add my little birds now. And let's see if we can find some good places for them. So I've got a right and a left to get in here. And let's put this little guy down at the bottom first. Let's put this guy down at the bottom. Oh, Pam, I could watch you and Kendra every day. Oh, how fun. Thank you so much. I'm so glad you're learning. This is why we do it. Kendra loves doing this. I love doing this. And I love seeing the progress that you guys are making. It is just the most rewarding thing. I can't even tell you how much I love that when I see how much people are improving and then making this technique their own. That's what I think my favorite thing is they just take it to the next level. They get their confidence, because that is everything, to just get your confidence, and then realize, you know what? You can be an artist. You absolutely can. You absolutely can. Okay, I'm stamping this little bird now on here, and I'm just going to put him kind of right here. I hope you can see this. And I'm just going to ink it one more time just to make sure that I have enough ink on here. And then stamp it off, because we really don't want this guy to be too dark. So I think that's a good spot right there. Perfect. Okay, so let's see if we can find another place for him. Maybe up here. Maybe kind of have him... How about up here? This is a good spot. Let's put him up there. Let's smooth this down so you can see where I'm putting him. Right up here, this is a good spot. I think I can get one more impression out of this. Okay, that's good. And then let's do the other one that's facing the other direction. This one is going to the right, so let's use the positioner on this one. This little guy. We just, you know, Kendra and I both, we just get really long-winded lately. I keep thinking, oh, this project should only take about 30 minutes, and here I am on over an hour. So I just can't believe that I am taking this long to get this project done. But, you know, when you're watching it, you know, the replay, you can always speed it up. So that's always really encouraging to me that you can do that. So I know that if you are in a hurry, you can just speed it up and, okay, there we go. So we're done with these little birds. So I'm going to go back to my really tiny brush and just pull the color out of the lines. And I'll hold it up for you to see too. So we'll just come through here, and mostly where the wing is, you know, where the head is, we're just pulling those colors out. Keep it really, really light. So there's the one on the top, this little guy, and this little guy down at the bottom. So I'm going to really go in here with my fine tip. This is really important that you put the eye back in. You know, when you're stamping on watercolor paper, it's really hard to get these tiny little details. And lots of times it's the eye and the beak that doesn't stamp super dark. So you want to be able to see that it's really, really dark on there. And I think that, you know, in my original one, I did these little birds in blue. So you can see them on here, they're in blue. But I think I will, in this case, I'm going to make them red. Let's put a little red breast on them, make them little robins, and really kind of brighten them up, because they kind of got lost on here and they weren't super bright. So let's put their little red breast in here and just really get some color in here. This is where a 1-inch brush really comes in handy. When you're doing these tiny little details. Just like this. And just come in under here with his little red chest. And then I would probably go back in and just do another coat just to really darken that up. And the same with this little guy. Okay, so we're going to now with that same brush, make sure you really clean this out when you're doing, when you're using red, make sure you really wash out your brush. So we're going to do a little shadow on here, a little shadow here, and then under here. So you can see that little shadow for that little bird. And you could, if you wanted to, just come in and just add a little grass behind him. Kind of finishes everything off. And just pull that color out of the lines. And let's just add a little more color to these little robins. They just don't take much at all. That's part of the reason I love putting these little guys in, because they're just so simple and they're so cute. They just add so much when you're doing these little pictures. Okay, one last thing. I think we're gonna put in this little branch. It kind of adds another detail in here. I just really like adding these things. And you know, you can put as much of this stuff in, greenery in, as you want to. It's totally up to you. And like I said, every time you do these, you know, they're going to turn out different. Let's put one up here. Maybe just one in there. Okay. Wow, you guys, are we getting finished? I think maybe we are. If you want to, you can darken the post. So you can turn your card like this. You can use your fine tip and go back to your ruler and find your post. So you can go like this and then take your fine tip and you can darken the post where you're seeing it, where you're able to see it. So let me just show you what I mean by that. So in here, back in here, you're not going to see a ton because we've got so much foliage and stuff on here. Could really darken this little area under here. This is what I mean by going back in later and seeing areas that you can really, really highlight. See how that just, you know, adding those shadows really, really makes a difference. Where do you keep and display all these art pieces? You guys. Hey, if somebody would like this, I'm not sure if I said this last time, but if somebody would like this, let me know that you want it and we will do a quick drawing and get it sent out to you. So I'm happy to give it away. I have so many of these samples that I love it. If you want it and you would like to have it, I would love to give it away to you. Okay, I can just see that I really want to really darken under these eaves. So I'm going to just kind of go through here and just really darken these areas. And this little guy here, you could kind of come up like this and, you know, this is kind of a thatched roof here. Add some more detail in there. Down in here. Anytime you can do something dark, you know, with a light, it's going to give you dimension. Okay, I guess last thing to do is sign and date. And there we go. Let me hold it up and just do a slow scroll through so that you guys can see. It's really simple. You know, it really takes a little bit of time, but it's kind of worth the effort. It really is. And it's all the same simple technique. It's just a different composition. And it would be really cute with a different animal. The little fox in here would be really cute. If you like dogs, if you're a dog person, put a little dog in the pot. That'd be so cute. You could add different flowers down at the bottom. Any of the flowers, any of the long stems are going to work. Your little filler flower will work. Any of the flowers are going to work. And then, of course, you can do whatever color combination that you want on here. So post on here that you would like to have it. I'll give you another couple minutes. I'm going to switch this camera back over now. And hopefully I don't lose you guys. So I'll flip this back over and see if there's any questions on here. Susan Long, please, oh please. You guys are so funny. I just love you guys so much. This is so fun. You're all so encouraging. And you know, stampers are people who make things for people. And I love that about this industry because I've seen that over and over again. You're making these things with someone in mind to give away. You want to give it away to someone. You want to encourage them. You want to put it in a frame. You want them to know that you are thinking about them, that you love them, and you're encouraging them. So I love that about people who are in this industry and want to create these things. Needs a little bee flying around for the queen bee. I think Kendra started that. Who started that with the queen bee? That is hilarious, you guys. That's so funny. Anybody have any questions now at the end? I will be back in 2 weeks. Be sure to, with another project, so it'll be another intermediate project. I'm still in the new release, so I will put something together really fun for you guys and that I think you will have fun doing. It will be an intermediate level, so it will be a challenge project, but I also love when you guys post. You know, when you take this on and you do it, you may be a little scared, but you do it and you do your best and then you post it. So I do love seeing that. Claire will pick a winner. If she's not on here, she will go through here and pick a winner. And I will happily send this to you guys. So I don't see any more. What number was the tiny brush? It is a one. It is a number one. We sell a one, a four, and a six. A four, if you're just beginning, will do the majority of your projects. I would start with a four only. And then when you're doing little tiny details, a one is so great. And this is a really, really nice brush. Let's see, your art's a treasure. Oh, thank you so much. Thank you so much for watching. Thanks for spending an hour and 20 minutes with me, you guys. I appreciate that so much. It was just a blast. I always look forward to this and teaching you new things. So I will also scroll through here and see if there's any other questions that maybe I missed. But be sure to post them on here, even after I sign off, if there's something that you are wanting to know. Okay, thank you so much. Check out the supply list for future lives. Check out Kendra next Tuesday. Check out Claire on Friday. She is awesome. We love Claire so much. And thank you so, so much for watching. I appreciate it. Thanks for spending your time with me. And I will see you next week. Well, not next week, in 2 weeks. Mm-hmm.